Now that you've created a video, you know exactly what it takes to go from an idea to its execution. The scripting, the filming, the editing, this process can take a whole day depending on the complexity of your video. Because for many of us, video editing is not a skill we master. And even if we're good at it, there is still someone out there that can do it a lot faster and better than us. My name is Sushi and I manage two YouTube channels. I have a team of 5 contractors working full-time for me. And for the past 3 years, I have been hiring thousands of contractors out of the most popular platform out there. And in this video, I am going to share with you 7 tips on how to hire responsibly and effectively. Hiring is so time-consuming. So the first tip I can give you is when you go into those job boards, don't even start browsing through the profile. It will take you so much time. What I can tell you is create your job post. Have the candidates come to you and not you chasing them. First of all, when you go and chase them, let's say you find a profile that you like and you contact them. Well, maybe they haven't been on the platform for the past 5 months. You don't know if they're going to answer to you. The profile might be outdated. You will be wasting so much time. I will strongly advise you to create your job post. And then the candidates will come to you and you know that they're already available. That will reduce your hiring time. So where should you look for help? There's 3 sites that I've used so far. Upwork, Fiverr, and onlinejob.ph. I use those 3 sites for different reasons. For instance, if I'm looking for a VA, I will go on to onlinejob.ph. To access the job board, it will cost you $69. On that site, you will find a lot of candidates, mostly for long-term positions. They're all from the Philippines, so their English is very correct. My experience with onlinejob.ph was very, very good. When I was first starting, I was able to get applicants at a very, very low cost. They work very hard, very polite. Of course, you have to understand and respect the culture. But as soon as you establish trust with them, they're very reliable. I mostly use onlinejob.ph to hire my VAs or writers, but for very, very short script. When I was able to hire more qualified help, I went to other sites. If you're looking for a VA, someone that will do a lot of little tasks for you and will be very reliable, onlinejob.ph is a very, very good site. Another one that I use a lot is Upwork. My current voiceover talent comes from Upwork. Also, my general manager, I hired him on Upwork and they're doing an excellent job. They've been with me for more than a year. And the other site that I use is Fiverr. On Fiverr, you find a lot of candidates, but I find it a little bit more difficult to find the right one. The quality on Fiverr, you have the worst and the best. So it can take a lot of time to find the right candidate. If I tell you that I have flour, egg and milk, and I ask you to cook me something because I'm hungry, what would you make? With flour, egg and milk. With egg and milk, you can make a nice omelette. With flour and egg, you can make some pasta. With flour, egg, and milk, you might have some pancakes. The reason I'm saying that to you is to understand that if I don't give you enough instructions, don't expect the results to be exactly what you want. If you give the video editor your B-roll, your A-roll, and ask him to make a video, I mean, this is not enough. You really have to give as many instructions as you can. The more instructions you give, the better the result at the end. You have to say B-roll, A-roll, this is the transition that I want, this is how long I'm expecting the video to be at the end, this is how I want the opening to be, 30-second intro, in between the shots I want the B-roll, when I use this transition, this is the sound effect that I want. That's how you talk to a video editor. You give them all the instructions. If you want the best results, give them as many instructions as you can. The next tip, creating your job post. You have to be very precise in writing it. I went through several iterations of my own job post until I find the perfect mix that got me the best candidate. So the first thing would be your title. ensure that on your title you put the most important information for you. For instance, if you're looking for a video editor and that you do editing yourself, what is the software that you use? If you're using Premiere Pro, make sure that the title says looking for Premiere Pro video editor. Don't say looking for video editor. From the title itself, you want to ensure that the candidates that will read your job post have the same software that you use. Don't even try to hire someone that uses another software. You're just setting yourself for failure. But if you don't intend to edit anymore or to do the last tweak, then yes, you can hire a video editor that uses a different editing software than yours. Also, do you have a budget in mind? Are you looking to pay per hour or you want to pay per video? I would strongly advise to pay per video because if you pay per hour, you're adding some stress onto you. You don't want to be spending time thinking about, is he really working on my video? How come he charged me for uploads? And so forth. If you pay per video, you don't care how long it takes him. The price will be the same. A fixed price per video. For me, that was the best decision I made. Or if you have two types of video, you can say videos under 8 minutes will be at this price and video above 8 minutes will be at this other price. And you really need to think about what you need from your video editor. How complex are your transitions? Are you going to provide them with B-roll, a subscription to a stock video site? Do you provide them with the background music? Will your voice need editing? How long will be the final video? How many hours or minutes of raw footage will the video editor be forced to sift through? What is the turnaround time that you need? Will they have a week to create your video or under 24 hours? You need to think about all those things that are important for you. And if possible, write all of that in your job description. In the job description, I explain exactly the type of video I'm doing. Because I want the price to be as low as possible, I make their job easy. So I provide them with templates, I provide them with instructions, I give them an access to stock footage sites. Because I'm publishing videos daily, what was very important for me is that the turnaround has to be quick. I ensure that I had that in my job post. You will receive a lot of responses. I receive between 20 and 80 responses every time I post a job. I don't have time to read all those responses, so I have a process to sift through. One tip that I can give you is to insert some type of code word in the middle of your job description, a sentence that says, when replying to this job position, make sure you write in the header, blue elephant. This way, when you start receiving responses, you can just see all the headers. And if the header says blue elephant, you know that this person has read your job post. If those two words are not included, you know that this candidate is just replying automatically to all the job posts that are created on the platform. When you will receive those 50 responses, you might find maybe 20 that says blue elephant. So it filters out the number of applications you will have to go through. When hiring VA or writers, I have another system. I essentially hire them from onlinejob.ph. And this is what I do. I will post a job saying I'm looking for a VA or I'm looking for a writer. And then I will tell them that if they're interested, they have to email me back. And of course, I have that code word, like blue elephant in the header. Then I have set up my Gmail account so that any email that comes in my Gmail account with blue elephant in the headline is tagged and the canned response is sent to them automatically. The response that I send to them is a link to a Google form where I ask them a lot more questions. The candidates see my job post, they reply by email, and then they go into my hiring form where all my candidates go through, where I ask them all the questions that I want to know about them. You know, what's your English level, your MBTI type, your DISC score, how many hours a week can you work, how soon, what are the tools that you know about. I do a skill assessment. Are you advanced, experienced, beginner, no experience? Any questions that comes to mind, I ask them. Also, what's your internet speed? Even more for video editor, you want to make sure that the internet connection is solid so that they can send you files and it doesn't take a day for them to send you a file or a day to download a file. Because I've been hiring a lot, I now have all the questions nailed down that I need to ask them. So when they fill out that form, everything gets into an Excel spreadsheet, and then I can filter exactly what I want. On that form, I always ask also for a long form answer so that I'm able to judge their English. There's many things. I make them go through a process to see if they can follow the instructions. Some people don't write blue elephant, so I don't see them. Some people don't want to fill out the form because it's too long. Well, I don't need them, right? I'm looking for dedicated candidates, people who are hardworking. So that's why I make them go through all those processes to judge their level of dedication. And now I have a nice Google form. I can see all the candidate responses, when they're available, their pay rate, what tools they use, their experience, link to their portfolio, all that into my Google Sheet. Easy for me to sift through, to put my filters, and to see which one I'm going to contact or not. At that stage, I'm trying to find the top three candidates, and sometimes I go up to five. Then I select those five candidates and invite them to a paid trial. I would pay between $10 to $25. I will ask them for a script. I send them my template, edit a video or 1 minute of a video. I ask them to send the results within 24 to 48 hours. You might want to skip that step, but for me, this is one of the most important because some people are just professional to answer and make themselves look good on a job application. It happens to me so many times. I would read a job application and say, wow, this guy is exactly what I need. And then I was so disappointed by the results. So don't trust your first instinct and leave yourself some room to really analyze other candidates because you might set yourself for failure. Instead of hiring one person directly and cut on hiring costs, I would strongly encourage you to do a paid trial and take between 3 and 5 candidates. So you set money for that. Hiring has a cost, yes. You take 5 candidates and you give them the same task to do, either to edit a video, to write a script, or to do some other task for you, but a real job. And so this is what I do. After they fill out the form, everything went onto Excel. From Excel, I selected 3 to 5 candidates. I emailed them back asking them, would you be interested in the paid trial? The one that said yes, I then gave full instructions, everything that they need to know about. You need to write a script. Here's the template. This is where you can get more information. You have to do the script and send it to this email address. And you will be surprised. Some candidates, they understand everything and they send you everything on time. Other candidates will be late and give you some type of excuses. And other ones, they will be sending you emails every hour because they don't understand the instructions. Did you say this? What did you mean by that? And so forth. Right away, I can see like the candidate that are asking me a lot of questions. Sometimes it's a great question that I didn't answer in my instructions. So that's great. I make a note so that I can improve my processes so that that question doesn't come back again. But most of the time, if they had read the instructions carefully, they would have found that solution. So that's a great way for me to know that this person will not be a right candidate because I want people that can follow instructions. After the paid trial, you start to really get a clear idea of who's the winner. It's only at that time that now I pick up the phone or I schedule a Zoom call. Before that, everything was by email so that I don't spend too much time. But now I schedule a call with every candidate. At that stage, I only have 1 to 3 candidates, so it won't take me too much time. Most of the time, I already know which one I want. But by doing the phone call, I'm able to answer any questions they have about the position. But it's mostly just in case there's any surprises. During that call, I confirm everything that was important to me, that they understand, like how many hours can they work? Is the pay rate okay for them? I reconfirm with them the pay schedule, the payment method. This is mostly what I talk on the last call. I don't give my answer right away on the phone. I tell them that I will contact them within 24 to 48 hours and let them know if they have been selected. It might look pretty intense, but by implementing all those steps in my hiring funnel, that's how I'm able to always find the right candidate for me. And it saves you a lot of headache down the line. Now that we've talked on the phone and exchange, I got a feeling of who they are, their personality. I take that time to really think through and review everything about the candidate. I review their references. I go back into the job board to see if I missed anything. After reviewing everything and made the decision of who I'm going to hire, then I send them an email to tell them that they've been selected and also to let them know that they're going to start the position by a 2-week paid trial. I send them all the information that they need to join the team, so our Slack account, the Google Drive access, so that they are ready on the first day that they're going to work. When people are on a paid trial, they usually do their best. They will work harder, the communication will be very fast, but don't expect that to last too long. At the end of the 2-week trial, it's very common that people start to slow down or that the quality will degrade a little bit. That's the reason why during the paid trial, you really have to pay careful attention and ensure that everything is right on. Because whatever you get, all the efforts that they will put during the paid trial, you have to understand that they're working at their maximum right now. That level of quality, energy, enthusiasm that you will see during the first 2 weeks, don't bet on it that this is going to be all the time this way. And this is totally understandable. During the 2-week paid trial, if you have any type of training material, that's right now that you need to give it to them, because they will read everything, they will test everything. If you don't want to be disappointed, you have to use those 2-week paid trial to test them on every task that you can have for them, so that you can see their level of dedication, if they learn fast, how's the quality, how's their attention to details. You put them through a real test during those paid trials. As you can see, there are a lot of little things to consider when hiring your first video editor or virtual assistant. And I really hope that all those tips helped you avoid any of those frustrations that you might face. Because I did face them a few years ago when I was trying to hire my first virtual assistant. I share my experience and many other tips like that in my online course about hiring and managing a team, building processes and templates to publish daily videos without showing your face on camera. And now, get out there and start hiring.